San Antonio Patterson Pre-Med, coming back to give you guys a little update. So, you know the old saying, no news is good news, and I have no news. So right now, I am still on the wait list at one of the medical schools, the medical school that I had an interview at. So as you know, they could keep you on the on the wait list until the first day of school. So waiting to hear back from them. In the meantime, but 2 weeks ago, I resumed my study for the MCAT just in case you have to retake it. I think if there was anything that needed to be better on my application, it was my MCAT score. So I'm studying to retake that just in case you have to take it, just trying to be proactive. So for this go around, just on the advice of other students who have gone this route before, I've decided to add UWorld question bank to my studying as well as the AAMC. So I think this time I'm going to focus more on questions and less on content and see if I can get a better outcome. So that's where I'm with that. At the same time, you know, I'm just trying to be proactive. So I've applied to a post-bac program that gives you a certificate in clinical anatomy. And so it's just a 6-month program, and there's also an MCAT component with that. So if I don't get accepted in the medical school and I get into this other program, I think I'll put my MCAT on hold and just retake it, not reapply for fall 2021, but apply for fall 2022. So, and I know for some of you guys, you're thinking, why would you wait that far out? You're already 46. And for those who don't know, I will be 47 coming up here in July. So, the question is, what is the goal? The goal is to go to medical school. I would rather go now, but the goal is to go at some point. So, I'd rather take my time, study, you know, get my application where it needs to be, present the best application that I can next time around and give myself a better chance rather than just rushing to do something because I could get the same outcome on my MCAT. So I think that was probably the weakest part of my application. And so, you know, if I can do better, then I want to do better and I'll take the time to do it. So that being said, I will, if I don't get in this next go around and I don't apply for fall 2021, I'll be 48 when I get to med school, but I will still get to med school, and that's the goal, right? So I have those things in the works. I already have my application in for the program. This program is in Chicago. It's at Rosalind Franklin University, and it is a portal program also. So I think you get an automatic interview once you go through this program, pending your grades, of course. So gearing up for that and everything that life has to throw my way. So I want you guys to stay safe during this pandemic. Also, with everything that's going on in the world right now, my message for you is to speak your peace and stand on your convictions and do what's right because it's right. And it can't get any more simple than that. So I'm going to leave it right there. I know this is a short video. I don't have a whole lot to say. Just want to also thank you guys for following me. Thank you guys so much for the comments. That encourages me that there's somebody out there that even watches these videos, but even more so that there are people out there who are really rooting for me and wanting me to have success in my endeavors. And I feel the same way about you. Whatever you're doing, whatever your goal is, whatever you're pursuing, I hope the best for you, and I hope that you pursue it with passion and that you just get the job done. So thank you guys a lot for following me. As always, subscribe to the channel. Show me some love in the comments. See you guys next time.